My name is Cynthia Richards. On behalf of Art Studio Gallery, I'd like to welcome all of you here today to our April Art and Coffee. We have Gerald Huber here with us today, and he's got a very interesting and exciting morning plan for you. Art Studio opened its doors in May 2007, and this month is just 4 years old. Our vision and mission is to promote contemporary art that's progressive, new, and innovative. We change the exhibitions every 2 months and promote both local, international, established, and emerging artists. At present, we have 3 artists downstairs, so please make sure all of you go down and see the exhibitions before you leave. It's on the first floor. Have any of you visited the gallery, or is anybody new to the gallery? All those who haven't, you must go and see it. At the end of this month, we have another exhibition that's coming up. It's all women. 5 women will be exhibiting, so try and make that one too. We have some of the artists that are exhibiting here today. There's one here, and some of the other ones will be coming up. And there's Aliyah here too. Try to meet up with the artists so you can talk to them too. In addition, we have to the exhibition, we have this monthly Art and Coffee. And we chose new and innovative topics to strive to make the whole artistic process interactive through live talks and art demos, which you have a seat today. We want all of you to have the knowledge to be exposed to benefit and experience art. We aim to make art a habit. Planned out today, we have a very interesting energy and inspirational session with Gerard. Gerard has worked very hard with a lot of attention to detail, so I'm sure you're all going to enjoy this session. Okay, now before I hand over to him, we've given you some comment sheets. Please make sure that you'll fill them up, because there'll be a small miniature as a gift to a lucky winner. So fill your names in, and all the best. So now let's celebrate art with Gerard.
Thank you so much. I'm totally happy, but also excited and nervous, because what I want to present to you today is completely unique. I did it the first time in Dubai. When I started the artwork more than 12 years ago, I never had the imagination that ever I would have the possibility to present to an international audience like today. And in Dubai, I was in Austria. I did a lot of exhibitions there in Europe, in Vienna, in Innsbruck, in the area of Munich. But of course, being here in Dubai is exciting and overwhelming. When I started the artwork in 1998, more than 12 years ago, it was an experiment. I will tell you the origin of the artwork, but it's funny because it was 12 years ago, this area was not developed. So both developed simultaneously together, the area where we are now, where I'm able to present the artwork, as well as the artwork itself. 12 years later, it seemed that it was supposed that we are going to meet here. First of all, there's one person who is very important who made this possible, because without Cynthia's passion to bring it here and to give me the opportunity to inspire you by her energy, the possibility would not have been possible. So first of all, I would like to thank Cynthia a lot for making this possible. So a little origami for Cynthia.
Thank
you very much. I promised to tell you about the origin of the art. Everything started with a vacation in Greece. It was 12 years ago. I was on the beach, I was in the water, swimming, and it was so overwhelming for me to be there, to hear the water, swimming on the water, snorkeling, fish, that I just simply wanted for myself to take this positive energy back to my home. And so I started to establish on the walls in my home some fish on the walls. A skull of fish on the walls. And I was very happy with that. The more friends who saw it, they were encouraging me then to bring that further, to develop it, to bring it to public. And I was lucky because then there was at first my first group exhibition where I had the opportunity to show to the public, same as in an international surrounding with you now. It was very exciting for me because showing artwork, showing something what you do privately with a creative process is very personal, and when you then open yourself and show to the public, it's exciting about to see about the reaction. And I got so much encouragement from the people there. It was a lot of media even there, and I know the people coming there tell me, where is the fish? So from this moment I knew I have to continue that way, and I started to experiment about that. So from this private oasis having in my home, I started to create further the technologies, the techniques of the artwork, as well as the vivid effects which I want to show you quite soon. And experimenting around, I found that for me, I do one red thread through my artwork. The red thread should be linked to water, because water is first for me is the symbol for life itself, and it's a very natural symbolic element, covering nature. For me, nature is the best inspiration. And so to focus it to one simple element, for me, water was the best element to symbolize the nature. Fish, for me, are the energy in the water. Of course, analyzing the later, during the artworks, analyzing the meaning of the fish, I found out that in many, many cultures, fish is a strong symbol for positivity, balance, good emotions, happiness. And for me, it's simple. The fish is an ambassador. An ambassador for the nature's pure and clean, happy energy. And that's the reason why I'm staying with the fish since these 12 years. So, from creating a beach oasis in my home, I then now found a way to the Oasis Beach, literally the Oasis Beach Tower. Since you already introduced myself, okay, I'm going briefly also from my side, Gerald Huber, my name. I was born and grown up in Austria, and I was very lucky because I grew up in an area with a lot of nature around, a lot of natural inspiration. In 2005, I moved to Dubai for my work, working in the area of wellness and spa, architecture and interior design. Very challenging, very interesting. I love every day to work and to be in this area. But there are some few things which are missing what I was used from my home. This is these very typically natural approaches. Here in Dubai, I have the impression that quite often all these artificial things, the buildings, the overwhelming wows, push away the nature. For me, the most important effect here in Dubai, or the elements in Dubai, is the sea, the water, and the sand, the desert. And it's astonishing for me that Dubai is not creating more out of the sand and out of the desert. The waves out in the desert, I love these places. And I even started to do some artwork out in the desert because it's a very inspirational surrounding. So for me, nature is the most important element, and not even only looking at the general part of nature, but starting to focus and look on little details in nature. There's so many beautiful and nice things you can discover and identify when you start looking closer at things, looking a little bit deeper, or activating all the senses, smelling some new fragrances. When you're just sitting on a bench, waiting for some appointment, maybe just try to smell what's around, look at some shadow effects, look at some little details. For me, that's inspiring, even if the place and the area I'm at the moment is not bad, fantastic. So, when asked, maybe I ask you first, what is the most important, or when you think back to the most memorable moments in your life, would be interesting that you reflect what comes to your mind, what was most important when you had the feeling of pure happiness. When I speak with people, I often hear, course, it's the interaction with people, being together with friends, with family, smiling faces. And the second most memorable thing is nature. When you had any moment which was barefooted, grounded in nature, maybe on the mountain, maybe on the beach, in the water, but what is linked to nature. And as you see, my art is kind of happy art. It's just taking natural happiness out into home places. For me, I think you can imagine how exciting it was for me when I exhibited and then seeing the reaction of the people, and I showed them, I will show you very soon, the effect of the artwork, because it's not even static, it's vivid, it's alive. And so it was fascinating for me to receive such an inspirational feedback from the people. Then people told me they took out something, not only the nice ambience of the artwork, but they took out something for their life. They took out something, inspiration, effect, encouragement, to do a step in life, to do something in a different way. And as an artist, it's so touching when you see that you can approach people's lives. And getting the feedback, I still know from all the artworks where it was sold, where there are any, I know every piece, and I still get feedbacks, phone calls, SMS on a yearly anniversary occasion to tell me what effect they still take out of these artworks. And this is the energy boost for me to have creative power, endless creative power to continue working sometimes through the night to the artwork. When I look to the, I arrange the artwork in a way that you see the different technologies I'm using. Here on the left side you see acrylic paint, so let's start with all the artwork here. Here is energy, is aluminum plates. It's difficult to imagine here, but the aluminum plates have a distance to the wall, so when you put it on the wall, you see already a shadow between the artwork and the wall, to have a kind of flying effect of the artwork, so that it's not typically stuck to the wall, but it's in a little distance flying the wall. So the aluminium plate, and then I'm using these artworks, which is examples of the artwork. Here you see acrylic paint technologies. Different techniques, different material, different gold inside, just the acrylic paint, or here inspired because G is also very much linked to G, the Chinese energy. So here you see in Mandarin language, Chinese language, a text which transfers also this kind of inspirational effect. It's saying dream. And from this side maybe you'll see, and later when you come around you will see on the fish there's another text saying comes true. Dream, which the inspiration is getting real. Other technologies here on this side and on the far right is some photo collages. Being traveling a lot, being in different places, I collect photos from different impressions, giving me good energy. And for example here, the artwork is called Exotic Fantasy. And in Exotic Fantasy, you see a mix of the water surface in Vietnam, you see the rice fields in Bali, you see a palm tree in Thailand, and swimming pool and some flowers. It's a mix of, I think in this artwork I was overlaying up 10 or 15 layers of different photos to get the effect, the underwater effect of this little miracle wonder world in the water. Over there, I was playing a little bit with the fun of the Arabian culture. This artwork is called Arabian Fantasy, and I'm using a swimming pool in Bahrain, together with a shisha on the creek of Dubai, together with some charcoals which I took in Cairo, from the same Cairo, yeah, and sun effects, etc., again, overlaid.